Are you already using Ableton Live as a part of your worship sets, but you're wanting to add a video, maybe like a lyric video, that has to lock in with that arrangement so beat for beat and word for word it matches with what the band is doing? Well, adding video to Ableton Live is actually a lot simpler than you might be thinking. Hey, it's Dave Dolphin at practicalworshipblog.com, sharing ideas, tips, and practical advice for the everyday worship leader. And recently got a question from Benjamin Reed, and he said this. Hi Dave, we're about to try triggering video from Ableton for the first time. I have no clue how to do this. What's a good starting point? Well, Benjamin, thank you so much for the question. It's actually a really good question, and incorporating video into Ableton Live is actually a lot less complicated than you might be thinking, because Ableton treats a video file just like it does an audio file. So all the things you can do with audio, you can do with video. So this is the computer over here that we use to run our tracks on a Sunday morning. And when we drag in a video file, it just goes on the timeline in the arrangement mode, in the horizontal mode, and you can see the waveform of the audio of that video, line it up where you need to so it matches the arrangement of the song you're doing. If you need to use the warp feature in Ableton, let's say that the lyric video is at 76 beats per minute, but your band likes to do the song at 78 beats per minute. You just set that up like you would anything else, and it's really, really easy. If you want to do the chorus again, let's say you do the chorus one extra time than what's in the lyric video, you just snip it and copy and paste like you would, and provided that the motion doesn't seem too jarring in the actual video, moving things around and manipulating it is actually pretty easy. So when you drag the video file into your Ableton session, or if you open up an Ableton file that already has a video linked in it, this little player window should come up. If it doesn't, then all you need to do is go to View and then go to Video Window, and it'll pop up. Now, similar to running maybe like a Pro Presenter station, you need to set up that computer to have two displays. One display that is like your control panel, the person can operate it and see all the controls, and then you have the screen that is the presentation side as far as like what people see. Like this screen right above me is the presentation side. So like if you have a laptop, this screen right here is gonna be your control panel, and then you might use the port on the side of your laptop as a second display, and that would be the presentation side. For our tracks, we actually run a Mac Mini, and so the display side is what's running this screen right here, and then we also use the HDMI port on the back of the Mac Mini to run to the switcher that goes to this screen that's right behind me. So with the two displays set up on your computer, you just need to take your video window, drag it over to the second screen that is your presentation side, you double click, and you have a lyric video. Probably a good thing to mention right here, just like on Pro Presenter, you want to make sure that your pointer, your arrow is on the main screen and not over here on your presentation side. Otherwise, you will see that as you run the lyric video. Now, every time you open that Ableton file, it's going to start with the video in the window, so not full screen, and it's going to show that window on the main screen, so not the second screen, the presentation side. As far as I know, there's not a way to make Ableton default to that video showing on the second screen in full screen. So what we do is right before service starts, we just make sure everything is set up, we drag it over, we test it, and then we leave it and we don't touch it. And when service starts, you hit spacebar and you're good to go. Now, if you're running on a Mac and you go full screen on that second screen and you're still getting this menu bar, making that disappear is actually a little bit harder than it should be. Harder because where you need to find it in the system preferences is in a really weird spot. You just need to launch system preferences, go to mission control, uncheck displays have separate spaces, log out, log back in, and now your second display should not have that menu bar, and when you go full screen with the video, all you see is the video. So that's how you can run video out of Ableton, like specifically using a lyric video where lining it up with the arrangement of the song matters. Here at Practical Worship, we love sharing ideas and tips and practical advice for the everyday worship leader with videos just like this one. So if you haven't already, consider subscribing to the channel. That way you know when new videos just like this one are uploaded to the channel. And share the love. You might know someone that might benefit from this information. Consider sharing the link on Facebook and Twitter and other places on social media. If more great practical advice, check out practicalworshipblog.com. I'm gonna go with that. Word to your mother. here she's nice.